Holly, I've had too many of these same conversations with you. And you have been doing this for 3 weeks. I've dealt with you for 3 weeks. I can even name everything you've done. Yes, ma'am. Well, I'm talking to a student right now. Can you tell them to wait outside, please? Thank you. Your teachers complain. You are disrupting the classes. You have bullied half the kids in your class. And your science teacher said that you cut off Sally's hair. Why would you do that? Well, you know what? I don't want to hear it. Because these are not excuses. I got a good mind to expel you. You almost cost this school thousands of dollars because you have pulled the fire alarm for 3 days. For 3 weeks. Every week, you've picked 3 days out of all the 3 weeks to pull the fire alarm. So, what is your deal? You know what? I don't care. I don't care. If you keep doing this, I will expel you. Do you like getting good grades? I mean, do you like your classes? Because you do get good grades. You're smart, but you are very disruptive, and you're a bully to the students. Why are you acting this way? You get good grades. You know what? I think you're full of bullcrap, and you're being childish. You need to grow up. Because this is straight up bull. Get your act together. Act your age. You are, what, 17, 18 years old. Okay? And you're acting like a 5-year-old. Get your act together. We do not tolerate bullies in this school. And if you keep it up, you will be expelled. You think I'm bluffing, but keep testing me. I promise you. Now, go to class. I said, go to class. Thank you. Don't get into any trouble. Hi, you must be Tammy. Yes, I spoke with you on the phone. I am very sorry about earlier. I had to take care of one of the students. They were misbehaving and I gotta tell you, they are such a handful. this girl that you just saw in my office. She is a nutcase. She's quite the character. Ever since she's been to this school, she has been nothing but drama. But anyway, that is not your concern. So I apologize for spilling that on you. That is very unprofessional of me. So, yes, you would like to get your children enrolled for this school. Yes. Yes, I am Marisol Mills. I am the principal here. Yes. And these must be your children. Hello. It's a pleasure to meet you. No, wait. Let me guess. You must be Jan, and you must be Mitchell. Mitch? Okay. So not Mitchell. Got it. So Mitch and Jan. Well, it is a pleasure to meet all three of you. Yes. Well, we won't be able to let them start today, but they can start Monday. But we can get them enrolled for Monday. Yes, they can come in at Monday. At, let's see, our school starts at 8 o'clock every morning. Yep. 8, from 8 to 3 o'clock in the evening. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Oh, I understand that completely. No worries. Okay. I need you and your children to fill this out, please. They will sign these two lines right here. And they will also fill out what classes they would like to take during the semester. So the classes are listed right here. And down here is extracurricular, so they can take extra classes for extra points. Yes, for their grades. So I'm gonna give that to you. Let you both sign it. Yes. Mitch and Jan. will pick out the classes they would like to attend. Let me get you a pencil. I prefer you fill it out with a pencil instead of a pen, so that way you won't have to redo all of the filling out and all that mess. So yeah. We offer scholarships from Harvard and Yale. But your requirements are to have A's and B's, mostly A's. You have to be an honor roll A student to get into those colleges. Yes. So Jan is a straight A student. Well, what about Mitch? Okay. So Mitch gets A's and B's. All right. Well, that's great. So he can get a scholarship as well for his A's and B's. And then Jan, since you're a straight A student, keep up the good work and you will get a really great scholarship as well. Oh yes. But the scholarships, let's say if you attend these schools, they are highly expensive. What do you want to major in? Mitch, what do you want to major in? So you want to be a science teacher. Okay. Jan, what would you like to major in? Okay. So you want to be a makeup artist. All right. Well, I think Harvard has cosmetology school. You will have to do some research. What else do you both want to do besides being a science teacher and a makeup artist? What are some goals that you have set for yourselves after high school? You have some bright children. Yes, Miss Tammy. They are very, very bright. Okay, now, all right, so you filled out these. Okay, let me go over this really quick. fulfilling that at? So, what other goals do you both have for yourselves? You've mentioned science. Cosmetology. So, Mitch wants to be a dentist. Well, that's awesome. And what other goals do you have for yourself, Jan? A drama teacher? Cool. Yes. Oh, you enjoy singing as well. Well, we have choir class at our school. Yes, we do. And I see that you picked that as one of your classes. So that's good. You will like your choir teacher. Yes, he's wonderful. He's been teaching here for about 7 years. Yeah. So you will like him a lot. He's very down to earth. And as for you, Mitch, you're gonna like your science teacher. Well, I think that's about it. We are going to go over some school ground rules. We do not allow cell phones in this school. Okay? I understand that, Miss Tammy, but we cannot make any exceptions. In half of Jan's classes are upstairs. Well, since she is disabled, she's not the first one, the first student that we've had in a wheelchair. We can move her classes downstairs if you're very concerned about that. Yes. If any time she's upstairs for whatever reason, like for a class or, you know, whatever, and we have like a fire drill or something, we do have staff members to help her get downstairs. Yes, we do have an elevator and it works, but not during a fire drill. The elevator during a fire drill will open, but you cannot go up nor down. So you're just basically stuck. So with her being in a wheelchair, the staff members, the male staff members, since they're strong men, they will carry her down the stairs with her in her chair. In her wheelchair. Oh yes, that's happened before. I've had several students that were in wheelchairs And we've had fire drills, and they were upstairs. And our staff members had to carry them downstairs while they were in the chair, you know. Yeah. So that was, that's what we do. No, ma'am, you don't have anything to worry about whatsoever. I mean, there's absolutely nothing to worry about. Let's see, what else do you need to know? This school is all about respect. So we all respect each other. Now, with that being said, you're gonna have students that want to be your friend, okay? And you're gonna have other students that will try their best to bully you. And anytime that they try to bully you, you know, come to me or come to Mrs. Gald. She's our guidance counselor. Yes, Celia Gald. Oh, you know her? Yeah. Oh, she's your cousin. She's y'all's cousin. Well, that's wonderful. Okay, so since she is a family member, you know, just like I said, come to me, come to, go to her. If you have any bully trouble, go to your teachers. Whatever, you know. We are here to help the students, you know, and the teachers, I mean, and the parents, you know, we are here to help everybody. Yes. Yes. Yes, we have regular pep rallies just like every school does. We have pep rallies sometimes. We have football games, like right after school. Some of it is just practice. In other times, we actually do play other schools. Yep. Okay, so I will talk to some people, like to the staff and all that. And I will see if Jan can have a cell phone with her. Okay? Just in case she does end up going upstairs for a class. I mean, we change schedules like crazy around here. Yeah, we sure do. Yep. So, is there any questions or concerns that you all have? Yes, Miss Tammy. Well, we are looking for a new journalism teacher. Yeah, that's what we're looking for. I had to think about that for a second. We are looking for a new journalism teacher because we've had three so far that just turned out to be a flop. And you are our fourth one if we decide to interview you and give you the job. But I've been talking to you for, let's just say, 26 minutes, and I already adore you. So I will be more than happy to interview you. So when would you like an interview? Right now? Okay. I will need to talk to you privately about the position that you are willing to take. So that means your children can go wait in the hall. Tell you what, let me have one of these staff members walk your kids around. Just to show them around the school a little bit. To, get them used to their surroundings before they start Monday. How about that? Eric. Eric. Come here, Eric. No, Eric, you're not going to do that yet. But I do need you to do something. I need you to give a tour to Mitch and Jan, please. They will be starting school on Monday. And I need to interview their mother for a journalism job. So why don't you just give them a tour, show them around, and come back in about an hour? Does that sound good to you, Miss Tammy? Okay. Thank you, Eric. All right, guys. Eric is part of our staff, and he is very, very nice. You guys will like him a lot. He's gonna show you around the school. Okay. All right. Thank you for letting me borrow your mom. Thank you, Eric. Okay, Miss Tammy. Let's start this interview, shall we? Oh, yes, you can ask me anything. Oh, yes. I know I sound very sinusy, very congested. I got some kind of sinus issues going on, but I'll be all right. I only had it for like 2 days now, so it's getting better. Excuse me. Oh, yes. I have had the flu shot. I've had all these shots that you could think of. So yes, I'm caught up on all of that. We do express to the parents that the children need to take shots as well before they enter this school. Like their enrollment shots. Your kids are going to have to get shots as well for their enrollment. So I hope that's okay. Excuse me for my sinuses. Ugh. So anyways. Do they have a primary doctor? Or a family doctor? They do? Okay. Well then, ask your primary doctor to give them all of their school shots. Okay. Yeah, before Monday. Yes. Mm-hmm. Right. As I said before, we encourage the parents to get their children to take all the shots required for this school. Otherwise, we don't allow the students that want to be enrolled in this school to come. We don't allow it unless we know they've had all the shots required. Like tetanus, flu, there's a whole lot. There's a big list of them. Yes, ma'am. All the students have taken all of those, except for maybe 100 students. And there is like 400 students in this school. So maybe I think a small group of them hasn't taken their shots yet. That's because their parents are not, they don't understand about that stuff. So they're not really like okay with the idea of doing that just yet. But I will give those parents a talk and I will express that they need to have their children take their shots if they want to keep attending this school. Oh yes, it's very important. You know, some of the stuff that most schools do for elementary children, we also do for high school kids. We check them for all their shots. We check them for lice. Yeah, we do lice inspections to make sure that they don't have any lice, because we don't want our students to carry such things. So we do head checks, ice checks every week. And if it's not every week, it is like 3 times a month. So we keep an eye on our children 24/7. Even though it's a lot of children, we still keep an eye on all children. So, how many jobs have you had? Tell me what your experiences are. Yes. Well, that is super great. Wow. Oh, really? Well, you seem like you know what you're doing. Yes. Oh, yeah. Well, we would love to have you. So, congratulations. You got the job. Yes, ma'am. You can start on the same day that your kids start school. Yes, ma'am. Your salary will be about $500 a week. You get paid every Friday. Yes, ma'am. Every Friday, $500. Oh, yes. That's why the teachers love teaching at this school. Yeah, they sure do. They love it. Well, I believe that's all I have for you today. As far as any more questions go. So, yeah, you are hired. You can start Monday when your children start school Monday. Yes. Oh, and here comes Eric with your children. Hey, kids. So, did you enjoy the tour? You think you're gonna like it? Here? Well, that's great. So I have great news for both of you. Your mother is hired. Yes, she's going to take the journalism job. She's going to be teaching journalism. How does that sound? Yes. All right. Well, I have to get back to work. I have a lot of papers to fill out and whatnot and all this stuff. And I have more meetings to attend to with other parents and all that good jazz. So it was a pleasure to meet all three of you. Yes. And I look forward to seeing all three of you on Monday. Yes. You enjoy your weekend. All right. Take care.